looking for a professional created LUT pack for your GoPro MAX 360 camera? You are at the right place. I am going to teach you to set up your GoPro MAX to shoot video from this to this. Yes, it is god awful ugly, but hold on. Shooting in native white balance and flat color help you to retain the most amount of information and the highest dynamic range. With my techniques and creative LUTs, simply drag and drop, you get this. Or from this to this. If you hate shooting in native flat color, I also have LUTs also work directly on top of regular GoPro color. And the best part is, they are free and comes with this color grading tutorial on both Adobe Premiere and DaVinci Resolve. So, what are you waiting for? Hit the download link in the description down below and follow along to level up your 360 footage with beautiful colors. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, the number one YouTube channel dedicated to 360 filmmaking for everyone. If you are a GoPro MAX user, you probably don't have time to worry about color grading or dynamic range. You just want to set your camera, hit recording, capture as much as you can, slap on a LUT that look like Sam Kolder or Chris Rogers, and ready for Instagram. So why native white balance and flat color? Why is that even there on your GoPro MAX? Well, GoPro MAX surprisingly has a really nice flat color profile if you shoot at native white balance. They don't call it lock, but it's kind of like a pseudo lock. After days of technical testing on my end, the flat color profile really maximized the dynamic range of the sensor, which is Sony IMX577. It has the widest gamma and raw sensor color without color matrix, very close to DNG or RAW. If you shoot a GoPro color and make a mistake in exposure, the detail in highlight and shadow are gone. That also affects your white balance. If a white balance is also off, for example, shooting indoors with poor lighting, the color is lost forever. The second problem of shooting in GoPro color, which is a bigger problem, is that the image in the GoPro color video file is already developed and it has enhanced saturation, contrast, and tone mapping. It is harder to do color correction and apply LUTs on top of it. Look at this example that shot on GoPro color. I applied the official Sam Kolder SK2 LUT. It looked like poop. But your Premiere does not support color matrix just yet, so there's no way to color grade native flat footage from your GoPro MAX. And that is why so no one used it until now. Introducing Hugh's Technical LUTs for GoPro MAX. These LUTs are not made in DaVinci Resolve, by the way. It is created in a professional coloring software called 3D LUT Creators with controlled settings and charted videos. It cost me a lot of money and time to make those for you so you can save time and money. Don't forget to give me a thumb up and share this video. Set up your GoPro MAX. Step 1. Before filming, set your camera white balance to native right here and also set the ProTune color to flat. I like to control my ISO always to be 100 except in low light. In low light, I set the shutter speed to 60 or even 120 and bump the ISO up accordingly. I will teach you how to remove sensor noise in this tutorial, so you're never afraid of ISO noise anymore and shoot with confidence in low light. I want to provide options of my LUT pack. It's not everyone like me want to deal with manual white balance in post. Here is native white balance and here is auto GoPro white balance. Let's pan to the shadow. There is a color chart I put under the bushes right here. There are a lot more detail in the native. So if you are lazy, at least keep the flat color to have a flat contrast curve. Use auto for white balance. Look at that. You still have a pretty good dynamic range, but now you also have the color back. In Premiere, add the lumetri color. For those super lazy viewers, all you need to do is to go to basic correction, add my GoPro MAX native flat to GoPro color technical LUT. Then you are done. Look at that. Before, after. Amazing. Let's compare it to actual GoPro color. If you look at her face, which is terribly lighting because she's facing the sun. I'm doing that on purpose to illustrate the point. Her face is less contrast and looks generally better than GoPro color. Look at the chart in the shadow. There are a lot more details. At least it gives you a good starting point to build your own look. My recommendation though is to standardize your GoPro MAX into Rec 709 or sRGB. So you can apply any third-party LUTs that build on an sRGB or Rec 709 to match your DSLR. Most of the time for serious videographers, GoPro MAX is not the only camera they are using. Here is how. In basic correction input LUT, we use GoPro MAX native flat to sRGB. It gives us a still pretty neutral look. This technical LUT basically adds the color matrix of the Sony IMX577 back in a non-destructive way. It gives you a starting point to color correct and color grade your footage to build your own look instead of looking like GoPro. Again, this is not a color correction or color grading tutorial. This is a tutorial on how to use my LUT to keep all the color information and details of your footage using native flat color. So you can start to build your own cinematic look. Rec 709 does not look better than GoPro color. And that is why I also provide some free GoPro MAX LUTs for you. But let's try the regular LUTs you get from the internet and understand why they don't work on 260 camera. Recently, there is a very popular creator LUTs pack that everyone is getting. Inside, it has some of my favorite YouTubers like Matt Komo and Sam Kolder. Let's drop in the SK2 from Sam Kolder LUT pack on the Creative LUT. Honestly, not bad. A lot better than drop directly on GoPro color. The reason why regular LUTs you bought on the internet will not work on GoPro is because they are all based on a log profile of that creator's camera, like Sony S-Log or Panasonic V-Log. We need to remove those log contrast curve and build it from ground up for GoPro MAX. That is exactly what I did. So now let's try my faithful recreation of the SK2. Look at that. It is a lot better. Just to be fair, we did not do any color correction. We just dropped two LUTs in the video. And it is a 360 video. Had Sam Kolder make any 360 video? No. We just recreate his look in a 260 video with a $400 consumer 260 camera. That is pretty impressive if you ask me. Now, give this to a professional colorless light, add some contrast back using curve. Let me just quickly do a Matt Komo style faded field look S-curve by kicking the tail up like so. Look at that. We got a nice contrast back without crushing the shadow. That is a really cinematic and film look in 360. Let's now find a video that is more Sam Kolder style. Here we have me in Taipei, Taiwan, shot on a GoPro Fusion on top of a hotel, sunrise in 360. Drop in my LUT, look at that. Before, after, before, after. Look at it in full 360. What makes this LUT so cinematic is it reduced the color into two tones, the sky to teal and the sun to orange. If you look at me again, my skin tone is protected. Oh, and yes, this LUT also worked great with old GoPro Fusion. Okay, what if cinematic is not what you are going for? You want something action sports. Like here, we have me snowboarding. We are gonna drop in the GoPro MAX Auto Flat Creative Sunny Outdoor Snow LUT, also available in the download. Immediately, we have this Chris Roger GoPro look, but in 360. Just to compare, here is my Sam Kolder look and here is the Snow LUT. The Snow LUT is designed for GoPro flat color if you want the best result. It will also work on top of GoPro Color as well. Because of the whole social distancing, I still do not get a chance to create any tropical beach and ocean LUT yet, but that is my next thing I'm going to create. So don't forget to subscribe for my free tropical LUT pack. Just to show you how versatile this sunny outdoor snow LUT can be, not only for snow, here we have our friend's base jumping, filming on a GoPro MAX and a FPV drone. The color is meh. Drop in the outdoor LUT, look at that. The color of the net is really pop and the sky is nice rich teal. You have to try this magical outdoor LUT that I spent hours creating in the professional calling software, the 2D LUT creator. This LUT will work in almost all 360 outdoor situation. What about indoor? Well, as you see right here, we also use professional lighting and a controlled environment to stress test our LUTs. But as the nature of a small sensor 360 camera, we will run into color noise or chroma noise when you apply a creative LUT based on Rec 709 from a traditional 2D workflow in low light area near the stretch point, which is the nadir and the zenith, top and bottom of your footage, like right here. I already made an in-depth tutorial on 260 noise reduction in Adobe Premiere using Neat Video. I highly recommend you watch that to understand noise, where it's come from, and how to remove it. If you switch to DaVinci Resolve following my latest series, well, you are in luck today. I am going to show you how to use my technical LUTs and remove those nasty chroma noise with Resolve free without any third-party plugin. That is also one of the major reasons why I choose DaVinci Resolve as my go-to coloring solution. Let me show you. DaVinci Resolve and remove chroma noise. So, if you are using DaVinci Resolve, I assume you are not lazy. You want to be better than your boy Hugh here, creating your own color and style instead of just copying big creators or me. So, I am showing you the typical coloring pipeline. If you have not already, let's install my LUT first. Open file location, and here is where you should drop in all my LUTs. Create a folder called GoPro MAX and drop in all the LUTs you download from me in here. Now, see my node structure right here. You never drop any LUT directly on your first node, just standard best practices. Here is where you correct your white balance and use the max benefit in shooting in native. Then, we apply my technical LUT to turn your footage into Rec 709 or sRGB. If you forgot already, it is the GoPro MAX native flat to sRGB LUT right here. I am using short key Ctrl D to turn on and off a node. The third node is where you are going to do your primary, and you can continue to add more node to do your secondary to protect skin tone and all the other good stuff in Resolve. This is not a color grading tutorial or color grading tutorial at all, but if you want one from me, especially in 360 VR, comment below and let me know. Now, the next node is where you add your look, your creative LUT like what you already learned in Adobe Premiere. Here, we are going to add my Sam Kolder LUT with light contrast. It just looks so beautiful. Look at her skin color. That muted look, just so cinematic. Can you believe that is shot on a GoPro? Well, let's play the video. If you pay attention, right here in the shadow, we see noticeable chroma noise. Chroma noise is color noise, by the way. So let's fix it by going to this tab right here, the motion effects. In Temporal NR, we use frames 3. It basically means Resolve will look forward and backward 3 frames to identify the noise. 5 will be too much for your computer to handle. I have a Titan RTX, so I can go 5 on no problem. Motion estimate type should always be better. Motion is small as our model is barely moving. In Temporal Threshold, unlink Luma and Chroma, we have more Chroma noise than Luma right here. So just dial in based on your footage and how much denoising you want. I'm also going to use Spatial NR as small sensor camera is usually very noisy. I am using Enhance and Media Radius. Unlink and only add Chroma here, around half of the Temporal NR value. We are also going to add sharpening in post as we always should in medium sharpening setting in our GoPro Max. That's what I will recommend at least. And trust me, it looks a lot better when you add sharpening in post-production with DaVinci Resolve. We will not have a real-time playback as this is a pretty extreme setting in a 5.7K video. So go ahead, just render it and bring it back into Premiere. Look at that! Premiere version, and here is the DaVinci Resolve version. Now, you will not be afraid to push your creativity and use some of your favorite 2D LUT in 360. Thank you for watching another very technical and in-depth tutorial on coloring with your GoPro Max. This workflow will also work with other 360 camera. I am also releasing technical LUTs for other 360 camera as well and improving what I already make for GoPro Max and providing more creative LUTs to supercharge your workflow to save you time and money. I have a homework for you though, in order to know what kind of look you like to achieve so that I can create that exact LUT for you, comment below and send me the sample link. Do you want to make your 360 films look like the Mad Max or look like the Jokers? I need to know. I spent days, if not weeks, on this because I really care about my subscribers. I truly hope you to learn to get better in your creative process. If you want to thank me and support me, give this video a big thumb up, share this video on your social media like Twitter and Facebook, and spread the love. If you use my LUT on your works, please give me a shout out, tag me on Instagram, and let me know. You have no idea how much I like to see your work and knowing that my knowledge is helping you to tell better stories. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new here and hit the notification bell to stay ahead of the game. And I will see you in the next tutorial or see you in virtual reality.